In this video, we'll see the call and return instructions present in PIC16F877 microcontroller. So first instruction is go to. So go to is actually an unconditional branch instruction. So the syntax for this instruction is go to K. So here K is the address of program memory. So the maximum address that we can have is 2047. So using this go to instruction, we can jump anywhere in the 2 kilobytes of memory space. So the operation that is performed is the address which is present in the instruction, that is in the form of operand, that is copied to program counter. So there is a 11-bit address which is related to 2 kilobytes of memory space. So that will be copied to program counter. And the remaining 2 bits will be taken from the PC lath register, which is present in PIC16F877 controller. And using these 2 bits, the page of the memory will be decided. So as we know that the program memory is having 4 different pages, page 0, page 1, 2 and 3. So out of those pages, which page is to be selected, that is decided using these 2 bits, that is bit number 4 and bit number 3 of PC lath register. So these 2 bits are loaded to bit number 12 and 11 of program counter. So the example is go to and label. So here label, you can give any name. So the program counter will execute this instruction and it will directly jump to the label where you have placed it in the program. The next instruction is call. So call instruction is used to call any subroutine. So we can write subroutines in the program. So these to call these subroutines, we have to use instruction call. So the syntax for the instruction is call and K. So again, this K can be anywhere in between 2 kilobytes of memory space. So the operation that is performed by this instruction is that the program counter address is incremented by 1 and that address is stored onto the top of stack. And at the same time, the K which is given in the instruction, that is nothing but the address of program memory where the subroutine is written, that address is loaded in the program counter and the remaining 2 bits are taken from PC lath register and those are loaded in the bit number 12 and bit number 11 of the program counter. So all these operations are performed whenever we execute the call instruction. So this call is a 2-cycle instruction. And most of the instructions in PIC are single cycle instruction, but this call instruction is a 2-cycle instruction. The next instruction is return instruction. So this return instruction is used to return from a subroutine. So whenever the instructions present in subroutine are completely executed, the last instruction should be return instruction. So when this instruction is executed, at that time, the address which was previously stored onto the stack, that address is now popped out of stack and it is stored in program counter. So that is the operation performed using this return instruction. And the program counter will come back to the main program. Next instruction is RETLW. So it stands for return with literal in W. So this is a similar instruction to return. Just the difference is that while returning from a subroutine, the value which is mentioned in the instruction, that value is loaded in the working register. So if L is there, it means that this whatever value we have written here, that is the data, and that data will be copied to working register. So using this RETLW instruction, we can return from any subroutine. So whenever we return from the subroutine, 2 operations are performed. One operation is that the value which is mentioned in the instruction, that value is copied to working register, and the second operation that is performed is the top of stack is popped out and it is stored in the program counter. The next instruction is RETFIE. So this instruction is used to return from an interrupt service routine. So whenever this instruction is executed, again 2 operations are performed. First operation is that the top of stack, which is having the return address, is popped out and it is stored in the program counter. And the second operation that is performed is the GIE bit, that is global interrupt enable bit, is made equal to 1, because whenever a interrupt service routine begins to execute, at that time all the interrupts are disabled by making this GIE bit equal to 0. So whenever the interrupt service routine has completely executed, at that time, whenever this instruction is executed, that is RETFIE, at that time, this bit is again made equal to 1 so that it can now again accept the new interrupts. So this is about the call and return instructions present in PIC16F877. In the next video, we'll see some of the instructions for creating loops. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.